श्री श्री निताय गौर हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय। श्री राधा गोविंद विग्रह नेम राधा मोहन। श्री श्री राधा मोहन की जय। श्री निताय गौर सुंदर की जय। साधु महाराज की जय। गुरु परंपरा की जय। निताय गौर प्रेमानंद। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीर वन चारी। यशोदानंदन ब्रज जन रंजन जमुना तीर वन चारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। राधे। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहार गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। राधे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Madhuri. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Please chant loudly.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Radhe Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare Hare Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol. Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol. जय राधा मोहन राधा मोहन राधे जय मोहन राधा मोहन राधे जय राधा मोहन जय राधा मोहन राधा मोहन जय राधा मोहन जय राधे जय राधे जय राधे जय श्री राधे राधा रानी की जय महारानी की जय राधा रानी की जय महारानी की जय राधा रानी जय महारानी की जय राधा रानी की जय महारानी की जय राधा रानी की जय महारानी की जय बोलो वृंदावनेश्वरी की जय 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 बोलो कुंडेश्वरी की जय 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 महारानी राधा रानी की जय महारानी की जय राधे 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 जय 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 राधे 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 जय जय राधा कुंज बिहारी राधा कुंज बिहारी राधे जय राधा कुंज बिहारी राधा कुंज बिहारी राधे जय राधा माधव राधा माधव राधे जय राधा श्याम सुंदर राधा श्याम सुंदर राधे जय राधा गोपीनाथ राधा गोपीनाथ राधे जय राधा श्याम सुंदर राधा श्याम सुंदर राधे राधे श्याम 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 राधे श्याम श्याम राधे श्याम 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 राधे श्याम 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 जय राधा रमण जय राधा रमण राधा रमण जय राधा रमण जय राधा मदन मोहन राधा मदन मोहन राधे जय राधा गोविंद राधा गोविंद राधे जय गोपीश्वर जय महादेव गोपीश्वर जय महादेव जय वृंदावन धाम जय वृंदावन धाम वृंदावन धाम जय वृंदावन धाम जय वृंदावन धाम जय वृंदावन धाम वृंदावन धाम जय वृंदावन धाम जय राधा कुंड जय श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड जय श्याम कुंड जय राधा कुंड जय श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड जय श्याम कुंड जय गिरि गोवर्धन जय गिरि गोवर्धन गिरि गोवर्धन जय गिरि गोवर्धन जय गिरि गोवर्धन जय गिरि गोवर्धन गिरि गोवर्धन जय गिरि गोवर्धन जय गौरनिताय जय गौरनिताय गौरनिताय जय गौरनिताय जय गौर हरि जय गौर हरि गौर हरि जय गौर हरि जय गौर हरि जय गौर हरि गौर हरि जय गौर हरि जय नित्यानंद राम जय नित्यानंद राम नित्यानंद राम जय नित्यानंद राम जय नित्यानंद राम नित्यानंद राम नित्यानंद राम जय नित्यानंद राम जय नित्यानंद राम जय नित्यानंद राम नित्यानंद राम నితాయి గౌరాంగ 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 నితాయి జయ గౌర హరి జయ గౌర హరి గౌర హరి జయ గౌర హరి జయ వృందాదేవి జయ వృందాదేవి వృందాదేవి జయ వృందాదేవి హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ నితాయి గౌర హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ హరి బోల్ నితాయి గౌర జయ గురు పరంపరా జయ గురు పరంపరా గురు పరంపరా జయ గురు పరంపరా జయ గురు పరంపరా జయ గురు పరంపరా గురు పరంపరా జయ గురు పరంపరా జయ భక్తి వినో భక్తి వినో భక్తి వినో జయ భక్తి వినో జయ కమల భక్తి వినో కమల మంజరి జయ భక్తి వినో జయ కమల మంజరి జయ భక్తి వినో కమల మంజరి జయ భక్తి వినో జయ గుణ మంజరి జయ గౌర కిశోర గుణ మంజరి జయ గౌర కిశోర జయ నయన మంజరి జయ భక్తి సిద్ధా నయన మంజరి జయ భక్తి సిద్ధా భక్తి సిద్ధా జయ ప్రభు పాద ప్రభు పాద పాద జయ ప్రభు పాద జయ గురుదేవ 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 జయ గురుదేవ జయ గురు
ಊರುದೆ ಗುರುದೇವ್ 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 ದೇವ್ ಗುರುದೇವ್ ಗುರುದೇವ್ ದೇವ್ ಗುರುದೇವ್ 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 ಜಯ ನಾಮ ಸಂಕೀರ್ತನ್ ಜಯ ನಾಮ ಸಂಕೀರ್ತನ್ ನಾಮ ಸಂಕೀರ್ತನ್ ಜಯ 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 ರಾಧಾ ಕುಂಡ ಜಯ ಶ್ಯಾಮ ಕುಂಡ ರಾಧಾ ಕುಂಡ ಜಯ ಶ್ಯಾಮ ಕುಂಡ ಹಲೋ ಶ್ರೀ ವೃಂದಾವನ್ ಧಾಮ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಶ್ರೀ ರಾಧಾ ಮೋಹನ್ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಪರಂಪರಾ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಅನಂತ ಕೋಟಿ ವೈಷ್ಣವ ವೃಂದ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ವೃಂದಾದೇವಿ ತುಳಸಿ ಮಹಾರಾಣಿ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಸಾಧು ಮಹಾರಾಜ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಶ್ರೀ ಸಮಾವೇತ ಭಕ್ತ ವೃಂದ ಕೀ ಜಯ ಆಲ್ ಗ್ಲೋರೀಸ್ ಟು ದ ಅಸೆಂಬಲ್ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಗ್ಲೋರೀಸ್ ಟು ದ ಅಸೆಂಬಲ್ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಗ್ಲೋರೀಸ್ ಟು ದ ಅಸೆಂಬಲ್ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಗ್ಲೋರೀಸ್ ಟು ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರು ಅಂಡ್ ಗೌರಂಗ ಓಂ ನಮೋ ಭಗವತೆ ವಾಸುದೇವಾಯ ಓಂ ನಮೋ ಭಗವತೆ ವಾಸುದೇವಾಯ ನಮೋ ಭಗವತೆ ವಾಸುದೇವಾಯ ಯಥಾ ರಾಧಾ ಪ್ರಿಯ ವಿಷ್ಣು ತಸ್ಯಾ ಕುಂಡಂ ಪ್ರಿಯಂ ತಥಾ ಸರ್ವ ಗೋಪೀಷು ಸೈವೈಕಾ ವಿಷ್ಣೋರತ್ಯಂತ ವಲ್ಲಭಾ ತವೈವಾಸ್ಮಿ ತವೈವಾಸ್ಮಿ ನಾಜೀವಾಮಿ ತ್ವಯಾ ವಿನಾ ಇತಿ ವಿಜ್ಞಾಯ ದೇವಿ ತ್ವಂ ನಯಮಾಂ ಚರಣಾಂತಿಕಂ ಶ್ರೀಮಾನ್ ರಾಸ ರಸಾರಂಭಿ
वंशी वट तठ चित कर्षण वेणु स्वनैर्गोपी गोपीनाथ श्रीयेस्तु नः ताप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये नमो महावदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नामने गौरत्विषे नमः नित्यानंद अहम नौमि सर्वानंदकरं परं हरिनाम प्रदं देवं अवधूत शिरोमणिं पञ्चतत्त्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे श्री श्री राधा मोहन की जय।
So Maharaj has asked me to speak about Gaur Leela. So today I would like to speak about Gauranga Ashtakaliya Leela Smaran Mangal Stotram by Rupa Goswami and Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. They have written 8 verses explaining the Ashtakaliya Leela of Gauranga in Navadvip Dham, which is corresponding to the Ashtakaliya Leela in Braj Dham. So when we in Dhyan Chandra Goswami's Gaur Govind Smaran Archan Paddhati, it is said that by meditating on Gauranga's Nitya Leela, you can effortlessly enter into Radha and Krishna's Nitya Leela. Gauranga gunete jure Nitya Leela tare spur Tara shei Radha Madhava antaram. Who wants to become intimate to Radha and Krishna? Please raise your hand. Everybody wants to become intimate to Radha and Krishna. So for that you have to dive deep in the transcendental qualities and the transcendental pastimes of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Jure, jure means to float. Gauranga gunete jure Nitya Leela tare spoon. If you float on the waves of the ocean of Gauranga's pastimes, then you will find yourself in the Nitya Leela of Radha and Krishna. Not only you will be there, but you will be very intimate to Radha and Krishna. Narottam Das Thakur, who is Champak Manjari, he is giving us the way into Nitya Leela. He is telling us, She Radha Madhava Antaranga. Antaranga means you receive Radharani's kripa and you receive your seva. You receive your swarup. Everything is there coming in Antaranga. So to become Antaranga, we have to understand Gauranga's Leela first. Prabodhananda Saraswati also says that in Chaitanya Chandramrita. Yatha yatha gaur padaravinda vindeta bhaktim krita punya ra thoda bada ho vindeta bhaktim krita punya rashi tata tata hrudai utsarpati kasmad radha padambhoj sudambhurashi. If you want to see Radharani's lotus feet in your heart, then you have to meditate on Gauranga's lotus feet. Gauranga ra duti pado jaro dhano sam pado she jane bhagati raso sa. One who accepts the lotus feet of Gauranga Mahaprabhu as one's life and soul can understand the transcendental pastimes of Radha and Krishna. So today we will start I will give you a brief introduction about Ashtakaliya Leela. Ashtakal. Ashtakal means one kal, Ashtaprahar. One prahar means 3 hours. And there are 8 partitions in the day and the night in Goloka, which correspond to the Ashtakaliya Leela of 3 hours each. So there are 24 minutes is known as one danda, and 48 minutes is known as one muruta. So there are 30 murutas in one day of Radha and Krishna. And corresponding to this, there are 60 dandas in 24 hours. So one danda is equal to 24 minutes. And the first period of the Leela starts from the Nishant Leela, which is from 3:36 a.m. in the morning to 6 a.m. in the morning. This is the Nishant Leela, which Radha and Krishna, they spend in the Nikunja, resting in a beautiful flower bed in Vrindavan after the Ras Leela. This is known as the Nishant Leela. So, during the Nishant Leela, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he gets up from his bed and he washes his face and he converses with his wife Vishnupriya Devi. Rupa Goswami has written a beautiful verse glorifying Gauranga's Nishant Leela in Navadvip, which corresponds to Radha and Krishna's Nishant Leela in Vrindavan. I will read the translation, then I will explain. My dear mind, I worship Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu, who at the end of the night suddenly awakens upon hearing the sweet warbling of the birds within the delightful flowering forest grove of Srivas Pandit. At this time, his whole body is intensely thrilled due to being aware of Lord Krishna being situated very close to Srimati Radharani. On their flower bed in the bower house in Vrindavan. Because of this, Lord Gauranga's ecstatic love is expressed instantly by wonderfully transcendental symptoms such as fountain of tears gushing from his eyes, which bathe his entire body. Just worship this Lord Gauranga, whose bodily complexion can only be compared to the shimmering, pure, molten gold. This is Rupa Goswami's first verse about the Nishant Leela in Navadvip Dham. In Srivas Angan, there are 3 udyans, there are 3 gardens. In the center is the garden of Gauranga. One side is Nityananda's garden, other side is Advaita Acharya's garden. So after dancing the whole night in Shiva Sangan and relishing the Rasa Leela, Gauranga Mahaprabhu goes and sleeps in his middle garden. And while he is sleeping in the garden, he is feeling Radha and Krishna. He is experiencing how Radha and Krishna also take rest at 3 o'clock and 36 minutes a.m. in the morning. After taking bath in the Jamuna, they go and take rest in a flower garden where the manjaris are serving Radha and Krishna. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu is remembering this Leela while sleeping in his own garden. And during his remembrance, whatever words Radha and Krishna are speaking in their sleep, in their yoga nidra, even Gauranga is repeating those words. Gauranga is conscious of Radha and Krishna. Just by remembering Gauranga, you can remember Radha and Krishna. So, sometimes in his bed he gets up, sometimes he sleeps, sometimes he is manifesting ecstatic emotions. In Radha Bhav, he is experiencing Krishna's embrace. On the flower bed, Krishna is embracing Radha in Seva Kunj. So Gauranga is experiencing Radharani's embrace. So all his hair stand on the end. And tears like torrents gush from his eyes. Just like the manjaris are serving Radha and Krishna in the Nikunja, in the night, in the Nishant Leela. Similarly, our Goswamis, they serve Gauranga in his Kunja, in Navadvip. Rupa Goswami, Sanatan Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami. Just like Raghunath Das Goswami has a seva Rati Manjari to massage the lotus feet of Radha Rani, in Gaur Leela, he, as Raghunath Das Goswami, he massages the lotus feet of Gaur Sundar.
Gaur Sundar ki.
Bhakti Vinod Thakur has the seva of bringing camphor as Kamal Manjari. He brings camphor to Radha and Krishna. So in Gaur Leela also he has that seva as a Kishore. All of you must be knowing from Jaiva Dharma, Bhakti Vinod Thakur explains that our Gaudiya Vaishnavas, we are aspiring for two spiritual forms. With one form we want to enter into Krishna Peet, the Vraj Leela, and with one Swarup we want to enter into Gaur Leela, in the Gaurapeet. One is the form of a Kishori and one is the form of a Kishore. So why we should aspire for only one when we can get two? Who wants two? You have to raise both hands. If you want to enter both the Leelas. So Gaur Leela is very ecstatic. In fact, Prabhupada Saraswati says that as a Kishore, you can relish even higher ecstasies in Gaur Leela. Because some Leelas in Braj Leela are not accessible to everybody. But in Gaur Leela, it's audarya. So Mahaprabhu is remembering Radha and Krishna sleeping on the flower bed in the Nishant Leela in the morning. Whenever we start our japa, if you start our japa in the Brahma Muhurta, we should start by remembering Gaur Leela. Then we should slowly enter into Radha Krishna Leela. The Brahma Muhurta starts 1 hour 36 minutes before sunrise. And it lasts for 48 minutes. Brahma Muhurta is only for 48 minutes. So we should remember Radha and Krishna first by remembering Gaur Sundar. First we have to remember our own Gurudev in his Kishore form, serving Gauranga in the Guru Parampara. Then we have to remember Gaur Sundar, and then we have to remember our Gurudev in the Kishori form, and then we have to serve Radha and Krishna in the Nikunja Leela. This is the paddhati given by Dhyan Chandra Goswami, also described in Jaiva Dharma. So, Ramananda Rai was asked by Gauranga, what is the highest of all smaran? Ramananda Rai said, Radha Krishna Leela smaran. Hai sarva smarane rasan. The essence of all remembrance is to remember the Nitya Leela. Narottam Das Thakur also sings. Narottam Dase Koi Nitya Leela Sukhamoy Sadai Spuru Kamora Mane Sadai
guru ka mor mane
nitya lila is sukhamoy, full of transcendental happiness, and may that nitya lila always arise in my heart. 24 hours, that is a prayer of Narottam Das Thakur. One who remembers the Nitya Leela while living in this material world, he is known as Jivan Mukta. Because he is not here, he is there. Ya yasya harer dasye karmana manasa gira nikila ashvapi avasthasu Jivan Mukta sa uchyate. So, one by remembering the Nitya Leela, we become Jivan Mukta. We remain always immersed in this Leela. We are not part of this material world. Seva sadhaka rupe siddha rupe na chashe. Amani manada sadarobe hridayate Radha Krishna sarvada sevive. Always serve Radha Krishna in your heart, 24 hours. Externally, remain as a sadhaka. Don't show externally. But internally, always meditate on the Nitya Leela. And that is only possible by meditating on Gauranga's Nitya Leela. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu is shimmering like molten gold in the Nishant Leela. Vishwanath Chakrabarti gives another commentary. He says that in the Nishant Leela, the cuckoos and the roosters, they are all started making the sounds. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu wakes up from his bed. With his wife Vishnu Priya, he starts discussing many sweet topics about Radha and Krishna. And they both become very pleased. Then he gets up and then from Shiva Sangan he comes to Yoga Peeth. And from Yoga Peeth he enters his room where he sits on a raised sitting place and his devotees, they wash his lotus face with nicely scented water. Thereafter, he happily visits his mother, Sachi Devi, and his other friends. And that is how the Nishant Leela of Gauranga Mahaprabhu is completed. Bolo, Nishant Leela ki jai. You also must be knowing in Govinda Leela Amrit, those who have read, you must be knowing that the end of the Nishant Leela, Radharani's monkey Kakhati starts shouting. How does he make the sound? Radharani's monkey. He says, Jatila is coming, Jatila is coming. Run, run, run. Female monkey, she is. Sorry, not male. So, Radha and Krishna get up from the bed. But the problem is, their hairs are so entangled with each other. They cannot go on their own way. Because Nandagaon is one side and Javat is one side. So when they want to separate, they look at the manjaris come and they disentangle their hairs, their necklaces, their garlands. And they are constantly looking at each other, they cannot bear that separation. This happens at around 6 a.m. in the morning, the Nishant Leela from 3:36 up to 6 a.m. it goes on. So, by 6 a.m. Krishna is already reached Nandagaon. And Radharani is already reached Javat. There is a big window in his room where Krishna secretly goes for Rasa Leela and secretly enters. Even Yashoda does not know. So the Nishant Leela goes in the flower bed in Vrindavan and then returning back to their own places And Gauranga Mahaprabhu himself also wakes up in his flower bed, and then he also returns to Yogapit and he meets his wife Vishnupriya and Sachi Mata. So that is how the Nishant Leela is completed in Navadvip and in Vraj Bhumi. There is lots of descriptions. Those who want to read about it can read it in our Nithai Veda. I have compiled in Gauranga Leela Amrit, which was originally written by Dashrath Suta Das. He did a very great service. The second Leela starts, known as Prata Leela. Prata Leela starts at 6 a.m. and it goes up to 8:24 a.m. I will read what Rupa Goswami writes about Gauranga's Prata Leela in Navadvip. After sunrise, Gauranga Mahaprabhu washes his moon-like face, comes out into the courtyard where he sits and speaks lovingly from the heart with extreme eagerness and at great length to his most beloved devotees about Lord Keshava's morning pastimes in Nandagaon. Bolo Nandagaon ki! The morning time. A Prata Leela is the most powerful Leela in Nandagaon, because Radharani comes to Nandagaon from Javat. This is the only time in the morning when Radharani is actually coming to Nandagaon. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu becomes very excited. He comes out in his courtyard in the Yoga Peet and he starts glorifying Lord Keshava's pastimes in Nandagaon. While speaking, he tastes with great relish the ecstatic mood of Radharani, which causes his entire body to fully blossom in transcendental jubilation. Dear mind, just perform your worship with boundless, unending pure love for this golden Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Lo Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki, Shri Navadvip Dham ki, Shri Yoga Peeth ki. All of you must be knowing how Kundalata is sent by Yashoda to go to Javat and bring Radharani back. So when Kundalata comes to Javat, Radharani says, I won't go. I am a chaste wife. Why should I go? I will remain in Javat. So Kundalata tells Jatila. Jatila says, you only convince Radha. Jatila convinces Radha. Radharani, you should go because Yashoda is invited. This is the only time when Jatila allows Radharani to go willingly. And that is the morning pastimes, Prata Leela. So when Kundalata takes Radha and Lalita, Vishakha and the Sakhis, and they go in the path from Javat to Nandagaon, Kundalata is describing how Krishna slept in the night and then what he did after getting up. And all these things Kundalata is describing to Radharani, and Radharani's body is erupting with transcendental goosebumps and ecstasy is manifesting on Radharani's body. And seeing that beauty, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, he remembers that, the conversation between Kundalata and Radhika. And when Gauranga Mahaprabhu remembers this conversation, he also experiences unlimited bliss. He keeps on speaking this Nitya Leela. He keeps on describing this Nitya Leela to his devotees in the Yoga Peet. Those devotees are so lucky to hear the Nitya Leela directly from the mouth of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So we can also be lucky if we meditate on these pastimes every day in the morning. That's why I remember when I was a brahmachari, it was very difficult for me to even take the morning prasadam. They had prasadam at 9 o'clock, but I would like to chant so much in the morning, complete all my 64 rounds in the morning itself. It was so nice to see Radharani cooking in Nandagaon during the Prata Leela. You can try to meditate on those pastimes while chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram Hare. You can see Rohini coming into the kitchen and the Rohini is praising the cooking of Radhika. Oh Radha, you have cooked so nicely. Just the fragrance of your bhoga will attract Shyam Sundar. And Shyam Sundar will faint in ecstasy. Oh Radha, you are the best cook. Oh Radha, you never cook the same every day. You are cooking different. Radha Rani's cooking is different every day. Every recipe is unique because it is mixed with her Mahabhav. Radha Rani never repeats her recipes. It is said in the Leela. Radha Rani ki rasoi har din nahi hoti hai Nandagaon mein. To Rohini ko aashcharya ho jata hai. Rohini feels surprised because Rohini is the master cook after Radha Rani. And Krishna is taking bath in Nandagaon. Gauranga Mahaprabhu is remembering all these past times. Krishna is giving bath by his servants. And Krishna is telling, quickly, quickly, jaldi karo, mujhe Radha Rani ka bhog khana hai. Krishna is always saying, quickly, quickly, give me bath. I want to meet Radhika. I want to eat the food prepared by Radhika. He is feeling very excited because the fragrance is coming to his nose, you know, even in that his bathing room. Radharani's cooking is, the fragrance is spreading all over Nandagaon, Nand Bhavan. So Krishna becomes very excited to meet Radha. In fact, when Krishna comes from the Goshala in the morning and Radharani comes from Javat, Radharani comes out from the kitchen and Krishna enters Nanda Bhavan, then both of them see each other in the morning once before Krishna goes for bathing. It is described in Govinda Lilamrit. So these are the divine pastimes in the Pratha Leela which one should meditate on while chanting the holy names. Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad says that in the morning after sunrise, Lord Gauranga goes with his associates to bathe in the holy river, Ganga. While bathing, they worship Mother Ganga by offering flowers, incense and different presentations. Then they come into the bank of the river where he is dressed with exquisite cloth and decorated with fresh flower garlands, sandalwood paste and other ornaments. Returning to his home in order to perform the opulent worship of Lord Vishnu as well as other rituals, they partake of the Mahaprasad which are offered to Vishnu after washing his hand and mouth. Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu goes into another room and rests very happily for a while. In this way, I meditate on the pastimes of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Bolo Gaur Sundar Bhagwan ki jai, Shri Prataho Leela ki jai. I'll tell you one secret which Bhakti Vinod Thakur used to say. In the Mahamantra, the first Hare Krishna stands for the Nishant Leela. And the second Hare Krishna in the Mahamantra stands for the Pratha Leela. There are in the Mahamantra also there are 8 padas. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. There are 8. So they stand for the Ashtakalya Leela. So when you say first Hare Krishna, you should remember the Nishant Leela. Then second Hare Krishna, you should remember the Pratha Leela. So in the Mahamantra, the Ashtakalya Leela is there. Don't think that the Mahamantra is incapable. The Mahamantra is fully capable to take us into the Nitya Leela. Because every 2 names of Krishna is equal to 1 Kal or 1 Prahar in the Mahamantra. Just like the cooking is beginning in Nandagaon, Radharani starts cooking and all the Sakhis help her to assemble all the ingredients and then she starts cooking. Similarly, the cooking starts in Navadvip. Vishnupriya starts cooking for Gauranga and his associates. Sachi Mata said, it is so late, Vishnupriya, let us begin the cooking. Very happy in her mind to receive this order, Vishnupriya immediately starts cooking. And Malini, Srivast Thakur's wife, helps in the cooking. And she is directed by Sita Thakurani, the wife of Advaita Acharya. So there is very lengthy leela of what kind of foodstuffs are cooked in Navadvip and what kinds of foodstuffs are cooked by Radharani in Nandagaon. So you can smell them. Actually, you can smell them while chanting. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram. But you should not smell them because it is bhoga. If you smell them, they are not yet offered to Krishna. But you can see, by remembering the Nitya Leela, you can actually remember all these pastimes. Then the third Leela starts, the Purvahan Leela, from 8:24 to 10:48 a.m. This Leela, as you know, this Leela is of Sakya Bhav. Krishna goes with Balaram to graze the cows in Govardhan. He leaves Nandagaon. So even Gauranga Mahaprabhu goes into Sakya Bhav. And Rupa Goswami writes, I worship the moon like Gaurachandra, who among his closest devotees remembers Krishna's forenoon pastimes of leaving for the forest to tend his cows. During this period, all the residents of Vraj come out and become greatly anxious due to Krishna's departure from their midst. Lord Gauranga is so absorbed in this intense remembrance that he virtually becomes fused with the Vraj Leela. Gauranga becomes fused with the Vraj Leela. Gauranga Mahaprabhu us Purvan Leela ke chintan mein itne magna hai ki wo Leela ke saath ek ho jate hain. Wo Gaur Leela ke Krishna Leela ke saath ek ho jate hain. Aur kabhi kabhi wo Gaur Leela se adrushya bhi ho jate hain. He disappears sometimes from his Gaur Leela. So he is so much intense in remembrance of how Yashoda is taking the hand of Balaram and telling, oh Baldev Bhaiya, your elder bhai, your big brother, you take care of Krishna, okay? While carrying the cows, tending the cows, you take care of him. Baldev is smiling, he says, who can take care of Krishna? So Gauranga is remembering all this. And Radharani with her sakhis, she is standing in a corner. She is watching Krishna go. It is also described in Govind Leela Amrita. Sometimes in this Purvahan Leela, Radha and Krishna take a short break, secret break, and they go to some cave near Nandagaon. Like sometimes they go to Ter Kadam, sometimes some place, and they have a small secret pastime. And then they come back, and then Krishna leaves with the cows. So Nanda Bhavan may be thodi thodi choti leela hoti hai, kabhi Radha Krishna ek nirjan sthan mein jaake thode samay tak leela karke, jaise ter kadamb hai ya pavan sarovar hai, wahan jaake wapas aa jate hain aur fir Krishna gayon ko charane nikal jate. When Krishna leaves, Gauranga Mahaprabhu is meditating on all these pastimes. Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur writes, upon arrival of the forenoon period, Lord Gauranga gets up from his nap, he stretches his body, then he washes his lotus face with sweetly scented nectar. Meeting with his devotees who are very fond of chanting Gaur Hari Nama Sankirtan, he personally tastes and relishes the chanting of the holy names. Thus he sports sometimes in the way, increases the ecstatic pleasure of all the townspeople so much that he attains the limitless heights. I meditate this, the daily pastimes of Gauranga Chandra. In Navadvip, Gauranga Mahaprabhu comes outside. In Navadvip, he starts dancing, remembering the Prata Purvan Leela. And remembering the Purvan Leela, the Navadvip Vasis also experience these ecstasies, the highest, by looking at Gauranga Mahaprabhu, divine dancing. So when you look at the form of Gaur Sundar, that form is actually the personification of Radha Krishna's Nitya Leela. Gauranga Mahaprabhu ka jo swarup hai Navdeep mein, wo Radha Krishna ki Nitya Leela ka murtiman swarup hai. Unka swarup dekhne se hi Radha Krishna ka Nitya Leela mein pravesh milta hai, darshan milte hai. Kyunki he himself is wrapped in meditation on Radha Krishna's Nitya Leela. The whole Navdeep Dham is meant for this purpose only. The whole Navdeep, all the Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, they are meant to increase the remembrance of Gauranga, of the Nitya Leela of Radha and Krishna, to make it, remind him of everything. Ritu Dweep is meant to remind him of Radha Kund. Ishodhyan is meant to remind him of Anang Manjari's Kunja. Everything is meant to remind him of Radha Kund. Godrum is meant to remind him of Nandagaon. So in that way, the whole Navdeep Dham is meant to increase the remembrance of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Next we come to the fourth period of the day, which is the Madhyan Leela, which is going on right now. From 10:48 to 3:36. This is 4 hours and 48 minutes. This Madhyan Leela. It is the highest of all Leelas. It is the crest jewel of all Leelas. Bhakti Vinod Thakur writes that those who are very advanced sadhakas, they chant in the afternoon time. From 10:48 to 3:36, you should chant remembering the Radha Kund's Leela. Radha Kunda Shama Kunda Giri Govardhan. Radha Kunda Shama Kunda Giri Govardhan. Kalindi Jamuna Jaya Jaya Mahavan. Radha Kunda Shama Kunda Giri Govardhan. Kalindi Jamuna Jaya Jaya Mahavan. This Madhyan Leela is the most nectarian, because in this Madhyan Leela, Radha Rani gets the association, Krishna gets the association of only Radha Rani and her intimate sakhis in Radha Kunda, which is the private lake of Radha Rani. In the private lake of Radha Rani, only Radha Rani and her sakhis can come. राधा कुंड है वो राधा रानी का निज सरोवर है. सो रूप गोस्वामी डिस्क्राइब दिस मध्यान लीला इन नवद्वीप. ओ माय डियर माइंड, कंटिन्यूअसली वर्शिप द सन ऑफ मदर सची लॉर्ड गौरांगा. हीज होल बॉडी इरप्ट्स इन एक्सटैटिक बम्प्स ऑफ शीयर डिलाइट व्हेन ही रिमेंबर्स दैट एक्सटेंसिवली वेरीगेटेड midday pastimes of Krishna sporting with Radha and the multitudinous of gopis. His voice stutters and chokes in excitement as he describes these leelas among his devotees, and thus he manifests the performance of plays and dramas which simultaneously correspond to the occurrence of the divine couple's pastimes in Radha Kunda and Sham Kunda.
Radha Kunda Sham Kunda ki jai.
At 10:48, Krishna goes with the Sakhas up till 10:48 with the Govardhan Leela at Gwal Pokhar. Krishna hands over the Sakhas and the cows to Balaram, and he slips with his Priya Narma Sakhas and he comes to Radha Kund. And Gauranga Mahaprabhu is thinking, meditating on every step how Krishna is coming to Radhakund and Radharani also leaves from Javat on the pretext of Surya Puja, worshipping the sun, and she comes to Kusum Sarovar. She starts plucking the flowers for Surya Puja, but actually she wants to pluck the flowers to decorate Krishna in Radhakund. On the Shringar Ghat, in Radhakund, on the west side of Radhakund is the Shringar Ghat, the Julan Ghat or the Bhojan Ghat. Krishna, being very anxious to meet Radharani in Radhakund, he arrives at 10:48. Krishna is sharp on time, because Krishna is remembering Radhakund all the time. All the time. Just like he remembers Radharani all the time, Krishna remembers Radhakund all the time. Yatha Radha Priya Vishnus Tasya Kundam Priyam Tatha. Radhakund is equally dear to Krishna, just like Radharani. So when Krishna cannot see Radha, he takes happiness in seeing Radhakund. Sees the beauty of Radhakund, he sees all the ghats. And Gauranga Mahaprabhu is so beautifully describing these pastimes to his associates. While speaking about this Leela, Gauranga Mahaprabhu himself is immersed in this Leela. That is very important. So, he describes his pastimes. Then Radharani comes from Kusum Sarovar. She comes to Manaspavan Ghat on the banks of Shyamkund to take her bath. For Radharani, Shyamkund is very, very dear to Radhika, because Shyamkund is the blackish waters, the beautiful waters of Shyamkund. Radharani, when she sees Shyamkund, Radharani feels as if she is meeting Krishna. So she enters into the Manaspavan Ghat and she embraces the waters of Shyamkund. That's why this Manaspavan Ghat is very dear to our Goswamis. Vishwanath Chakravarti took bath every day in Manaspavan Ghat. His bhajan kutir is just after that pilu tree. You must have seen his bhajan kutir in Shyamkund. Then Raghunath Das Goswami also used to come to Manaspavan Ghat. Because when Radharani is taking her bath, she needs the seva of the manjaris. They have to take care of her clothes. They have to prepare for some towel and all these things from some shringar. So in Manaspavan Ghat is the seva of all the manjaris. So they did bhajan there in Shyamkund. And after taking bath in the Manaspavan Ghat, Radharani meets Krishna in the Sangam. The Sangam is between Radhakund and Shyamkund. That is the Mahayogapit. Like there is a Yogapit in Vrindavan, in Radha Govindevji's temple, there is Yogapit in Radhakund, between the two kundas, the Sangam, that is the Yogapit. Yogapit, why it is called as a Yogapit? Yoga means union. Milan.
Joint.
Yoge. Yugal Milan. So, Radharani comes from Shyamkund after taking bath, and Krishna takes bath in Radhakund. And because of taking bath in their respective kundas, they become qualified to meet each other. राधा रानी से मिलन करने के लिए भी कृष्ण को राधा कुंड में स्नान करना पड़ता है. जस्ट टू यूनाइट विद राधिका, कृष्णा हैज टू टेक बाथ इन राधा कुंड. वृंदा देवी इज गाइडिंग हिम एंड दे मीट इन द संगम एंड देन दे एंटर इन टू द वॉटर्स ऑफ राधा कुंड एंड दे स्टार्ट योर वॉटर पास टाइम्स. दे आर अनलिमिटेड दिस वॉटर पास टाइम्स. गौरांग महाप्रभु ऑल्सो एंटर्स इन टू द लेक इन ऋतुद्वीप. There was a beautiful lake. Now that lake has disappeared. In Navadvip, there is a island known as Ritudvip. In Ritudvip, all the seasons are present simultaneously. That is why it is known as Ritudvip. Because in Radhakund, in the Ashtasakhi's Kunjas, around Radhakund, all the seasons are present simultaneously. So this Radhakund is manifested in Navadvip as Ritudvip. So when Radha and Krishna are in the water, Gauranga Mahaprabhu also is in the water. In his own lake. And he is splashing water on his associates. Just like the gopis, sakhis are splashing water on Radha Krishna. Gauranga is also doing these water pastimes. And he is remembering these pastimes. His intimate devotees like Rupa Goswami can understand the mood of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, Gadadhar Pandit. They can understand the mood of Gauranga in these Madhyan pastimes. Because they are pastimes in Madhurya. So in that way, Vishwanath Chakrabarti Pad writes, during the midday period, Lord Gauranga continues to enjoy the performance of intensely enthusiastic chanting and dancing, surrounded by his own dear associates like the moon-like Advaita Acharya, Gadadhar Pandit, and the divine madman, Nityananda Prabhu. Afterwards, they all wander throughout the gardens and the groves on the bank of the Ganga, where they enjoy the sweet cooling breezes blowing over the river, hearing the pleasant sounds of the bumblebees and the birds. In those gardens, the Lord remembers these ecstatic pastimes as Radha and Krishna, which are occurring simultaneously in his forest of Vrindavan. I thus meditate on the daily pastimes of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Shri Madhyan Leela Ki Jai. After taking bath in Radha Kund, then Radha and Krishna enter into Anang Manjari's Kunja in the center of Radha Kund. Then they sit down in the Shringar Ghat where they are dressed and where Champaklata and Vrinda bring nice bhoga, cooked bhoga for Radha and Krishna, feed each other with their own hands. And then there is a big Jhulan Yatra. It's a big jhula with 1000 petals described by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. They have the swing pastimes on Radha Kund, and after the swing pastimes, they have the Kunja pastimes. Kunja Bihari. When Bhakti Vinod Thakur writes, Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Bihari, that Kunja Bihari means Radha Kund. He goes around in the Ashtasakhi's Kunjas, and then finally he reaches Sudevi Kunja at 3 o'clock, 2:45, 3 o'clock, where in Sudevi's Kunja on the south side of Shamkund, they play the Pash Khela. Pash Khela. Radha Krishna, they play the dice game. And in the dice game, Krishna and Radha, they wager each other's favorite objects. And ultimately, Krishna loses his flute. Krishna apni murli ko haar jate hain. Pash khela mein, Radha Kund mein, 3 baje. 3 baje se leke 3 baje ke 36 minute tak. Ye leela hoti hai. And Radha Rani quietly takes the flute. She puts it in between her sari. And she walks away. Because the Leela is ending at 3:36, Jatila is coming already, she is outside Radha Kund. So everybody has to leave. So they are leaving. And then after Radha Rani has left, Krishna realizes, my flute is not there. Then Krishna runs to Surya Kund to get back his flute. That is another pastime. Then the fifth Leela is, we are actually running short of time, so I'll try to. Okay, thank you. Aparahan Leela is the fifth Leela, the Pancham Leela in the Ashtakalya Leela. That is from 3:36 till 6 p.m. in the evening. And from 3:36 to 6 p.m., this is the Godhuli Leela of Krishna. Krishna comes back, he unites with his sakhas, with his cows. And then he plays his flute. He calls Kalindi, Brahmari, Dhavali, Kesari, all his cows coming. And then Krishna takes the cow, takes them back to Nandagaon. He plays with his sakhas on the way. In Pavan Sarovar, he washes his cows. He gives them, makes them to drink water. In that way, This is the Aparan Leela. Rup Goswami describes this. Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu remembers the sun, the king of Vraja, who returns from the pasture grounds in the noon, an event which produces unlimited ocean of bliss for all the residents of Braj. Remembering within the core of his heart, Lord Gauranga dances throughout the town of Navadvip, spinning around while exhaling deep ecstatic sighs, thus becomes completely enchanted. He enchants the townspeople so much that they become helplessly stunned in divine love. Oh my dear mind, just worship Shri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. तो ये नवदीप वासी धन्य है जिनको गौरांग का नृत्य का दर्शन होता है अपहरण लीला में. इन दिस लीला द नवदीप वासीज हैव दर्शन ऑफ गौरांगस डिवाइन डांसिंग एंड गौरांग इज रिमेंबरिंग द गो धूली लीला. दिस गो धूली लीला इज द सुप्रीमली ब्यूटिफुल लीला ऑफ ब्रज बिकॉज इट गिव्स हैप्पीनेस टू ऑल द डिवोटीज, द काउस, द ग्रास, those who are in Shanta Ras, those who are in Dasya Ras, Sakya Ras, Vatsalya Ras, Madhurya Ras, all the devotees enjoy the Godhuli Leela. Sab raso ke bhakt Godhuli ka aswadan karte. Pure 10 ras hai. 5 primary and secondary, Gaun Ras.
Wo Chan Leela mein, 10 rason ka varnan hai.
Very nicely explained, all the 10 rasas are present in the Godhuli Leela. And there is one very very sweet Leela which occurs during Godhuli, is when Krishna coming from far, Radharani climbs the palace in Javat along with her sakhis and she waits on the terrace looking at Krishna to come. And Radharani is experiencing so much separation. Her body is becoming hot. All the sakhis are fanning her continuously because she is waiting for Krishna to come. And Krishna is also very excited. He starts behaving very strangely. Madhu Mangal says, Krishna, keep your secret. If Balaram comes to know, so Krishna tries to control himself, but he is so excited to come to Javat. On the way from Govardhan to Nandagaon, he comes to Javat and he is very excited. He waits outside Radharani's palace. He is just playing with his cows. And Radharani feels so blissful seeing Lord Gopal in Godhuli from the top of her terrace. She runs down with her sakis. When Krishna comes near the palace of Radharani, they come down and they come out of their door. Haan, jarur, jarur, jarur.
Take a shlok.
Jarur, jarur. To ye Godhuli ke time jo ye leela hoti hai, Radha aur Krishna ka milan Javat mein hota hai. जब कृष्ण गायों को लेके वापस आते हैं, राधा रानी नीचे उतरती हैं अपने महल से, ऊपर से देखती हैं और कृष्ण का दर्शन करने आती. शी कम्स डाउन एंड शी ग्लांसेस साइड लॉन्ग ग्लांसेस. राधिका डी गोणे हेरी नयो नेरको दिस फॉर्म ऑफ गोपाल इज सो अट्रैक्टिव टू राधा रानी. The first rays of sunshine in Radha Kund, they fall on Radha Gopal. In Radha Kund, there is Gopal Dev. You must have seen Gopal Dev. The first rays of sunshine, they fall on the lotus feet of Gopal. So, Gopal Dev is very attractive for Radharani. Then, after that, Gopal goes to this Pavan Sarovar, which is made from Vishakha's father, Pavan Gop. He has made this Pavan Sarovar to for Krishna's cows, to serve Krishna's cows and sakhas. So the 9 lakh cows, they enter from all directions in Pavan Sarovar. And Krishna is telling the cows, hua, 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 hua. Come, come, come. And then they come close to the water, but they are not drinking. So Krishna says, Neeri, Neeri, Neeri. Neeri, Neeri means you drink the water. Pani peelo. Gayon ko bolte hai, Neeri, Neeri. And then when after the guy, when they come more close to the water to drink the water, Krishna just... So the cows start drinking the water of Pavan Sarovar. And they are drinking and drinking and drinking because they know that is Krishna's order for them. So they are raising their tail and they are drinking. Then ultimately Krishna says, now it's time to go back. Krishna says, Tiri, 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 Tiri. Come back. Come back to the Tir. Tir means the shore. So you come back. He calls all the cows in Pavan Sarovar. Sanatan Goswami did bhajan in Pavan Sarovar to remember all these leelas. Sanatan Goswami is in Madhuri Ras. You may ask the question, why did Sanatan Goswami did, he is Lavang Manjari in Radha Krishna's leela. Why did he do bhajan in Pavan Sarovar, which is the dham of the cows and the sakhas? There is one reason for that. Because when Krishna is making the cows drink the water in Pavan Sarovar, Radharani comes from behind and she climbs the tower in Pavan Sarovar. There is a big tower made by Pavan Gop. She goes up that tower and she is looking at Krishna. She sees the leela of Pavan Sarovar. That tower is situated in such a way that from that tower you can see Pavan Sarovar also and you can see Nanda Baba's Goshala also. So after from Pavan Sarovar, when Krishna takes the cows to the Goshala, Radharani can see both the leelas from that tower. So that's why Sanatan Goswami did bhajan in Pavan Sarovar, remembering the Godhuli leela of Krishna and the meeting of Radha and Krishna. So that is the Purvahan leela, and Gauranga Mahaprabhu is very, very excited and he dances throughout Navadvip. Because Krishna is moving during this leela, Krishna is moving with the cows. So Gauranga Mahaprabhu is also dancing. Brajati iti braja. Braja means Krishna is always moving with the cows. So Gauranga is also dancing in the streets of Navadvip. During this splendid, beautiful afternoon period, Lord Gauranga and his devotees all become equally maddened in ecstatic love. And thus they expand the ever-increasing waves of auspicious benefit that ripple all through the three worlds. He satisfies the eyes of the townspeople just as the moon satisfies the chakora bird with the moonbeams. Reaching home, Gauranga is met at the door by his mother and lavished with loving attentions. I meditate on the daily pastimes of Sri Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Bolo apaharan leela ki jai. The sixth leela is the Shayan leela. The Shayan leela of Radha and Krishna and Gaur Sundar. It is from 6 o'clock to 8:24 in the night p.m. Rupa Goswami says, then Krishna takes his evening bath and his dinner and performs many fascinating pastimes around the sunset time. Then Gauranga Mahaprabhu absorbs himself in thinking of these pastimes again and again with great relish. In the circle of his own dearmost devotees, he constantly follows along with wonderful pastimes. Dear mind, just worship the moon-like Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Vishwanath Chakrabarti Path says that the Lord puts on fresh silken clothes and is adorned with flower garlands. Then he worships Lord Vishnu at home by doing the evening aarti ceremony, offering ghee lamps and other items. That is why we sing the Gaur aarti in the evening. And then he and his friends partake of the betel nuts and the fruits which are offered to Lord Krishna. So I meditate on the daily pastimes of Gaur Sundar. These pastimes from 6 o'clock to 8:24 are known as Shayan Leela, where Krishna is given bath, then he goes to his Goshala and he milks all his cows. And all the cows are not giving milk. Nanda Baba is trying a lot, but the cows are not giving milk. But when Krishna enters the Goshala, immediately all the cows, you know, they start moving when Krishna enters the Goshala, and all their tails go up. And when Krishna does all these things, he takes his pila pitambar, kas dete hain apni kamar mein kapde ko, and he takes a golden bucket given by Nanda Baba, and he puts the golden bucket in below the cow, and just Krishna is touching the udders of the cows to milk the cows. when Krishna is about to touch the cows in supreme ecstasy, the milk starts flowing from their udders in supreme happiness, and all the cows, the tears start coming from their eyes, and all the cows start giving milk instantly when Krishna enters the Goshala. Feeling the presence of Krishna, the cows are waiting for Krishna. Krishna touches them, their body, and the cows experience the highest happiness. Krishna is himself milking the cows. That is why it is said in the Brahma Samhita, Shirabdi Shravati Surabhibhyasya Sumahan Nimeshar Dhakyo Va Vrajati Nahi Yatra Api Samaya Bhaje Shveta Dvipam Tamaham Iha Golokamitiyam Vidantaste Santa Shiti Virala Charakati. Golok Dham is known as Shveta Dvipa because the cows are constantly pouring milk, hearing Krishna's flute and Krishna's touch. They are always giving milk in the Goshala. That is the evening pastimes. Then Krishna comes back and Krishna has his dinner in Nanda Bhavan again. But Radharani does not come in the night. Radharani prepares the bhoga and she sends it to Nandagaon from Javat via Kasturi Manjari. And all the other gopis, they bring the bhoga to Nandagaon in beautiful golden pots covered by white silk cloth. And then this bhoga is served to Krishna in the night as dinner. And Krishna is tasting the preparations of Radharani, which Radharani has made in Javat. Bolo Shayan Leela ki jay. The second last Leela is the Pradosh Leela. In the Pradosh Leela is from 8:24 to 10:48 p.m. in the evening. In the evening, Srimati Radharani travels to the pre-assigned pleasure grove in the company of her gopi friends and waits impatiently for Krishna to arrive for their secret rendezvous. When she receives news from a messenger about the activities and the whereabouts of her beloved Lord Krishna, her heart is completely overwhelmed with most intense anxiety. Oh my! In exactly that same mood, Lord Gauranga travels to the courtyard of Srivas Pandit in the evening, walking hand on hip as Radha does, like this. Afterwards, when she realizes that Krishna has indeed arrived before Radha, Gauranga jubilantly dances and stumbles repeatedly, his body erupting in intense euphoria with torrents of tears and shivering limbs. Just worship the fair complexioned Lord Gauranga Mahaprabhu. In the evening, there is a secret meeting on the bank of the Yamuna between Radha and Krishna in the Kunja. Sometimes they take a bath in the Jamuna also, they swim in the summer season. So, all this is described in the Govinda Lilamrit. So, at that same time, Gauranga Mahaprabhu also leaves Yogapit and he comes to Srivasangan, and he also moves around in the grooves of Srivasangan. And he's also having a hand like this, like Radharani. You know, Radharani is waiting for Krishna to come. Radharani is waiting. The hands on his hips like this. So Gauranga also is putting his hand on his hips like this, waiting for... And when Krishna comes and there's a meeting of Radha and Krishna, then Gauranga is very happy. He jubilantly starts dancing in Srivasangan. That is the mood of the Manjaris also. Radha Krishna Milone Ami Sukhamani. Radha Krishna Vyo Ami Dukhete Mori. So in Gauranga Mahaprabhu's pastimes, you can see the mood of Radharani and the manjaris also, because manjaris are the twigs and the leaves of the creeper of Radharani. So manjaris experience the same bhav as Radha. Manjari means the reflection of Radha's mind. So even Gauranga Mahaprabhu experiences his emotions. When Radha and Krishna meet, he is very, very happy. He starts dancing jubilantly. And when Radha and Krishna separate, Gauranga Mahaprabhu faints on the ground, unconscious. Blood start coming out from his pores. He feels very much separation from Radha and Krishna. Feels so sad. In that way, the Pradosh Leela is completed. Now we come to the last Leela, that is the Nisha Leela. There is Nisha Leela and there is Nishant Leela. So Nisha Leela is before Nishant Leela, from 1048 to 336. Morning AM. Rupa Goswami described this. My most worshipable Lord Gauranga is joyfully surrounded by his loving devotees in Srivat Pandit's courtyard at night. There he immerses himself in the transcendental ocean of congregational chanting. Holy names internally absorbed in the divine rasa dance of Sri Sri Radha and Krishna in Vamshivat. He also dances wildly in a state of tearful shivering and overwhelming jubilation. After singing and dancing to his heart's content, he goes to a quick, quiet flower garden and enjoys a feast of forest fruits and served to him as he reclines upon a jeweled bedstead. Thus, the son of Sachi Devi is the most deserving of my wholehearted, selfless worship, and he especially wanders in the Srivas Angan, Srivas Udyan with Gadadhar Pandit, because in the Ras Leela, Radha and Krishna, they wander in the Kunjas. So he goes with Gadadhar Pandit and he wanders in the forests of Srivas Angan. So in that way, this is the Nisha Leela of the Lord. That is why the most important Leela Sthali in Gaur Leela is Srivas Angan. Srivas Angan is the place, the hub of the Nitya Leela. In the Nisha Leela, the Nishant Leela, and even the Pradosh Leela, the Shayan Leela, there are 3-4 Leelas being done in Srivas Angan. That is why Bhakti Vinod Thakur, whenever he used to go to Mayapur, he used to do Hari Katha, Bhagavat Katha in Srivas Angan. Srivas Angan is the hub. All the Leelas start from the Yoga Peet, and the Lord comes back to the Yoga Peet. Like Nandagaon is the hub in Braj Leela. All the Leela starts from Nandagaon and the Lord comes back to Nandagaon. Ashtakaliya Leela ka kendra hai Nandagaon. Vaise Navdeep mein Ashtakaliya ka Leela ka kendra hai Yoga Peet. But Srivas Angan is a very, very important place. If one wants to get deep into Gauranga's Nitya Leela, then one should very carefully understand the descriptions of Srivas Angan and meditate on the descriptions of Srivas Angan, then the whole Gaur Leela will become very clear in your heart. Jo Radha Kund, Shyam Kund ki Madhyan Leela hai, and who, whatever descriptions in Govinda Leelamrit we meditate on Radha Krishna's Leela, we should also correspondingly meditate on the beauty of Srivas Angan. So in that way, up to 336, from 1048 to 336, again 4 hours and 48 minutes in the night, Radha and Krishna, they perform their Rasa Leela, and then their Jalakrida, then their Shayan Leela, they are resting in the flower bed. So this 1048 to 336 is the time for dancing. Like the morning 1048 to 336 is the time for water pastimes, this night 1048 to 336 is the time for dancing. Nutya. So in that way, let us all meditate on Gaur Sundar, his divine pastimes in Navadvip, and let us all become qualified to enter into Radha Krishna's Nitya Leela. Thank you very much. Shri Gauranga Mahaprabhu ki, Shri Radha Mohan ki, Nitai Gaur Premanand. Pandit will, Prabhuji will describe some. Anybody has any questions also, you can ask after. Speaker lena padega pura. I am very, very grateful for Sadhu Maharaj for giving this. I wanted to meet Sadhu Maharaj in Radha Kund this time, but invitation was late. I think all of you came, but we couldn't. Yeah. But please.
I will come.
Yes, Maharaj. Very nice.
Prabhuji, I have one question.
Yes. दो मिनट जरा इनका प्रश्न उत्तर दे दो.
Because there is all the time a past time is all the time is same.
All the time?
All the time is same.
Same.
Every day.
Same. Same.
Means it's called not possible to something else past time.
Actually, every day there is different past time. There is no past time is repeated. Every second it is fresh. Every second it is new past times. But the locations may be the same. But the way of reciprocation, the dancing, the jalakrida, everything there is variety every day. Different ways. Yes. No, this Bhauma Vrindavan has a connection with the Golok Vrindavan. So, even in this Bhauma Vrindavan, the Nitya Leela which is going on in Goloka is reflected in the form of Aprakat Leela going on in Bhauma Vrindavan. So, here also Aprakat Leela is going on which we cannot see with our eyes. That is a reflection of the Nitya Leela going on in Goloka. So by coming to Braj and doing bhajan here, we can enter that aprakat leela, then we can enter into the nitya leela. Because it is the whole Braj has come down with Krishna when he came. Any question? Yes. 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 Yeah, the goal is you should be able to meditate on the Leela while chanting without taking the book of Govind Leelamrit and holding it in front of you. But in the beginning, reading these pastimes is known as Bhakti Rasayan. It helps those Leelas to. Otherwise, if we simply imagine those Leelas, we may be speculating also. So in the beginning, it is important to follow the Shastra, and according to how they have described, we should meditate on those Leelas, and slowly when the Leelas get manifest by Swechha Purvika in your heart, then they will start arising in your heart. Then you will start seeing new Leelas, fresh Leelas. Then you will become an Acharya, you can write your own book. So both are necessary. We should hear also and then meditate also. Yes.
Thank you, Maharaj, for your great explanation. I would like to ask you a question. As the other devotees mentioned before, it always confused me. The timing that you mentioned from this time to that time, these things happen. But we always heard that in the
Goloka. A good question. In Goloka there is no material time, but there is spiritual time. Just like there is natad bhasyate suryo na shashanko na pavaka. In Gita it is said there is no sun, but in Govind Leelamrit said there is the sun is arising and Krishna wakes up. There is sun is setting in the night, there is Purnima, there is Amavasya. Everything is there in Goloka. So that is a transcendental moon, transcendental sun. There is transcendental time. Actually, ultimately the time is so slow in Goloka. Like if we go to Brahma Loka, it's like one day in Brahma Loka is 8.64 billion years on this earth. 24 hours in Brahma Loka. So if you go further to Brahma Loka, if you go to Brahma Jyoti, Vaikuntha, Ayodhya, Dwarka, Mathura and then Goloka, you can imagine how the time is hardly become... the time is not there at all. It's present continuous. But still our Goswamis have given us a paddhati in which during the times of this day in this material world, we can meditate on those Leelas which were going at that particular time in Goloka. You may ask, you may say that at that time they may not be going on in Goloka, because in Goloka some other period may be going on. But the meaning of Nitya Leela is that this Nitya Leela is Nitya. Even though it may be not be going on in Goloka, it may be going on in some other universe. In some other universe, it may be 1048 to 336. So the Nitya Leela is not only in Goloka, but the Nitya Leela also takes place in these universes. Like in one universe, when Krishna kills Putana, immediately the next moment in another universe, he will kill Putana. Like that, Krishna, there are billions of universes in this material world also. So the Nitya Leela is going on there also. So the Nitya Leela is Nitya. You can meditate on any Leela at any period of the day. Like if you want to meditate on Radha Kund's Leela in the night, you can meditate. If you want to meditate on Ras Leela in the afternoon, you can meditate. Because the Leelas are going on always. Maharaj, you want to say something?
In connection with this, because like in ragas, there is also time.
Yes. Yes.
We have to use ragas. If we use in different time, it's not inauspicious.
Yes.
Is it like also time?
Yes, the ragas in the North Indian musical system are also as per the times. Bhairavi and... my mother will know more about their... What is the morning ragas? So, morning, evening ragas are there corresponding. But I personally am more attracted to our Gaudiya Vaishnava ragas. In our Gaudiya Vaishnavism, there are three systems of kirtan. One is known as Garnahati, the other is known as Manohar Shahi, and the third is known as Reniti. Karnahati was the tunes which were sung by Narottam Das Thakur. Manohar Shahi was the tune sung by Srinivas Acharya. And Reniti were the tunes sung by Shamananda Prabhu. So our three systems are different from the North Indian classical systems. Our Gaudiya system, these three are different. And these three can adapt themselves to any of the Ashtakalya Leela. Like if somebody knows pure Manohar Shahi or pure Garnahati, you can sing morning raga, evening raga in Garnahati itself. But somebody has to know that pure raga.
You mentioned something about your book. You have it here?
Which one?
You said something that you have written a book. Yeah,
I have given to Maharaj. Unfortunately, I have not brought more copies of that. I will send it. I will send it for you by tomorrow. I am they are naam cards. Some the important shlokas I am from Gaur Tattva. I am beginning with Gaur Tattva, then I will go into Hari Naam Tattva and Krishna. Then with photographs, and I am explaining meaning by meaning. But they are available on our website. I will give you the card.
What is the website?
I will give the card. So, any other questions? Maharaj, you want to say something?
I have one question.
Yes.
My English is not so good.
No problem.
This love is transcendental love.
Yes.
All time. But this, what is the difference to transcendental love is the mood, is rather mood, and this material love.
Yes.
From mother to soul.
Yes.
What is the difference? Or is it...
Kama prema donhar vibhina lakshan. Lau ar hem tar swaroop vilakshan atmendriya priti vancha tar balikam krishne endriya priti ichha dhare premana. The thing is, all the love, so called love, the love which you see in this material world, every love has some selfish desire. We want our senses to be satisfied. Even in the mother's love for the child, the mother is getting satisfaction by loving that child. Some satisfaction the mother is getting. So there is some element of enjoying ourselves. Whereas in the love between Radha and Krishna, there is no desire to enjoy ourselves.
I pray Radha and Krishna to give me this chance to prove this love.
Yes.
Interesting for them.
Yes, it is Krishnendriya Priti Ichha Dhare Prem Naam. Prem and calm. This is the difference. It is like iron and gold. love or a hymn. This love in this world is like iron, and that love is like gold. More it is put in fire, it shines. If you put iron in fire, it will become coal, charcoal. So there the gopis have only one desire, that is to satisfy the senses of Krishna. Even when they went for the Ras Leela, the gopis had no interest in their own enjoyment. The gopis came simply to satisfy Krishna. That was their only desire in all the pastimes. And because of that selfless love, the real selfless love is known as Adi Ras. Adi Ras is the original Parkiya Bhav of the gopis. That is real prem. Another reason is that the Krishna's body is Sachidananda, gopis' bodies are Sachidananda, everything is transcendental. So there cannot be any lust. There is love. But in this world, our bodies are like earth, water, fire, air, ether. It is made up of material elements. So we are not when we are loving somebody, we are not loving the body. We are actually loving the soul. The reciprocation in this world is between the soul. But we give too much importance to the body. When the body is dead, then we don't no longer love that person. We cremate that person or burn that person. So the love is very temporary in this world. As long as the body is there, that love is there. But in the spiritual world, the soul itself is the body. That's why the love is pure and never ending, eternal. Thank you.
Yeah, my drug war, yeah.